One of the things that disturbs me most as we've been discussing the restructuring of the banking system is very little attention has been focused on what kind of a banking system do we want going forward.
I keep asking that question.
And the point is, for instance, we have banks that are too big to fail.
Right.
The administration's view of, you know, you're going to keep these zombie banks alive and say we can't let them fail. If you really believe that, that means we have to put all these big banks under government-type supervision.
But isn't that the mistake Japan made?
And that's right. But going forward, the other issue is we have to start breaking up the banks. If we are going to allow banks to become so big that they can't fail and we're afraid to restructure them, then we don't have ordinary capitalism anymore. We don't have the ability of markets to provide money and take risk-taking because there's no risk. The government will bail it out.
We haven't had ordinary capitalism in more than a year, right?
That's right. But the real question is, the real question is going forward. And if we are going to say, if we come to a crisis, we are going to bail these institutions out, then we have to admit we don't have a ordinary banking system going forward. And that means that we really, you know, we have two alternatives in my mind. We either have to break up these big banks horizontally and vertically, or we have to say these are public utilities that have to be regulated like a public utility and just, you know, regulate the salaries, you know, don't allow them to engage in excess risk taking, all kinds of things that are different from the way that we've been treating them.